On a serious note here this morning, these statistics we're about to tell you about are frightening. One in 54 people will be diagnosed with invasive melanoma. We've got Dr. Mary Noelle George here with us this morning. She's a dermatologist with SSM Health DePaul Hospital. You're here to break down the stats with us this morning. And my big thing here is, despite all these warnings, we have you guys telling us constantly from dermatologists, wear SPF, and just the warning, the risk of melanoma and how deadly it truly can be. Why are we seeing these rising numbers?
We think it's because of increasing sun exposure to ultraviolet light, not only from the sun, but increase in use in tanning beds and tanning salons.
Yeah, so I couldn't believe just a few weeks back, I was going to get a spray tan, full disclosure, but I saw so many younger kids there. I mean, I'm sure maybe junior high age, even early high school, they were there to go tanning. And there have been so many warnings out there. Why do you think people are still continuing to go in a tanning bed?
Tanning is an addictive behavior, so people really feel the need to go, to continue to go. It makes you feel warm. It's hard being in St. Louis in the middle of winter with fewer hours of sunlight, but it is, you know, it's still a very popular activity for young teens to do. In Missouri, unfortunately, we don't have good laws and regulations to limit their use.
But then, of course, you're seeing more cases of melanoma pop up, and this is a deadly disease.
Yeah, the increasing incidence of invasive melanoma, that's gone up in the past 5 to 7 years, and even more rapidly is rising the incidence of in situ melanomas, where melanoma is just in the very top layers of skin. That's gone up from 1 in 78 people to 1 in 58 people just from 2009.
And there is a big correlation, right, between a severe sunburn and a melanoma. That's a major thing that you want to avoid.
That is correct. Yep, we think over a lifetime, greater than 5 blistering sunburns significantly increases your risk. But also the tanning beds. We think, you know, even just a few visits to a tanning salon can increase your chances of melanoma by 60%, which is alarming.
It is alarming. And so many people forget, too. I mean, even though in Missouri, you know, it's cold, it's winter, there isn't a ton of sunlight all the time, but it's still so important to wear sunscreen all the time.
Every single day, 365 days a year. So I tell my patients, even if it's snowing in February and you're not going outside, the little bit of sun we get from windows through car windows, just going about our daily activities, is enough to cause cancer over time, and not to mention wrinkles and fine lines that nobody likes.
Nobody wants those either, so definitely keep it on your face. Is there anything else we can do, or things that maybe we wouldn't think about, just simple things in our everyday lives that we can do to kind of reduce our risk of getting melanoma?
Right. Seek the shade. Limit your time outdoors, especially during the more intense hours of sunlight, which is usually between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. Just be smart about your daily sun exposure.
And if you have any questionable moles, too, get into a dermatologist right away.
Make sure you see your dermatologist. Any new moles or any changing moles, it's very important.
The earlier, the better, if I'm correct, with
yes.
melanoma.
Like any cancer, early detection is critical. And ones that are caught early have a cure rate of almost 100%.
So get in right away. Dr. Mary Noelle George, thanks so much for
Thank
joining
you.
Us this morning. Wear your sunscreen, folks, even in the winter. Mike, back to you.
Some